Yeah, thank you. So how to write an introduction and material and method? So the introduction is basically the summary of the gist of the paper. Almost as we write on the introduction for the thesis, so whole of the summary, and in the end there will be an answer to the question, and you will be discussing that in the results and discussion. It should be written in such a way that it must create a good impression. If your this abstract and introductions are very good, and your conclusion, so many times the paper is usually accepted, and readers usually get a strong view of the rest of the paper from the first couple of your paragraphs in the introduction. It should be concise and well structured, with coherent flow of coherent and smooth flow of the thoughts of the topic in a summarized way. In a nutshell, it conveys what the reader is going to encounter in your paper, as well as why he want to read this paper. So from the introduction itself, he will make his mind whether he want to read this paper or not. It should be written in such a way that you should think about the questions or the problem, as already this has already been discussed many a times, that you will pose to at the outset, as well as the answer, how the argument that constitute your answer is to be staged in the introduction. Writing a good introduction should be straightforward writing, very simple way. Very long sentences, avoid long sentences, very simple, very simple. No too many citations. There should not be so many references in the introduction. Then it will become very, just like a discussion. No extraordinary long sentences should be used with multiple ideas separated by commas and semicolons. My English is not very good. There is a very good teacher in different department, and I don't hesitate to give my publications before my sending my article to him, so that, and so many times, a three-line sentence, he will cut half of the sentence, and he will make rest of the sentence in two sentences, and usually the English improves. And there is no harm of taking any, even of English, a professor of English, if you give paper to him, just he should not change the ideas of the paper, just to improve upon the English. It is, if your English is good, and the chances of this acceptance of the publication increases proportionately. My English is not very good, I can speak. No too many passive sentences should be used, and heavy use of nominalization. There should not be so many adjectives, so many passive sentences. Avoid this. Keep the paper as simple as it possible. So introduction is the roadmap, as this will help you write the rest of the, and there are two ways. Some people, they write down the whole of the paper, and then they will think that I will write down the introduction now. Some people say that I will write down the introduction first, and then I will build upon the whole the paper. There can be any two ways. Sometimes we have to modify again. We have written the whole paper, and then we can even improve upon our introduction also, so that it becomes more impressive. So any way you can be, you can do that. Sorry. This paper I have taken as a prototype. And this R.J. Grimer, he has published so many publications in orthopedic oncology. And he published this paper as a chondroblastoma bone and long-term results and functional outcome after intralesional curettage. Very simple. Now, in this paper, from this title, we can see that he is going to discuss the functional outcome and other, he has raised the question, which we shall come. Now, this is the, now in an introduction, the first paragraph, a generalized paragraph about the disease. What is the disease? Like in this case, he has discussed everything about the chondroblastoma in first paragraph. The term benign chondroblastoma was coined by Jeffrey and Lichtenstein, this is the historical aspect, to describe a rare neoplasm with a predilection for the epiphyse of the long bone, that it is, in the, it is the epiphyseal tumor, thus distinguishing it from giant cell tumor of the bone. Some feature of the chondroblastoma has been recognized earlier by that author, and also he called it a giant cell variant, but the codeman was the person who said that it is epiphyseal chondromatous giant cell tumor. So this is the historical aspect. Then he said a little bit about the its percentage in 1%. Then he wrote down where it occurs, which age group it is there, and the most lesions are seen in adolescents, like that, and the common presenting feature is, in one line, that swelling and limitation of the joint, sometimes synovitis. Then he described a word about the histological aspect of this disease. This can be just like a smooth flow. First, historical aspect, then percentage, then a little bit of clinical aspect, then a little bit of population, then histological aspect, that it is basically chondroblast is the cell of the origin, and chicken wire calcification is the main. Then he discussed a little bit about that 10 to 15% of the lesions are associated with large fluid species. This means he has said that there can be a secondary ABC also in this. Then he recommended a little bit in one line, what are the recommended treatment till date? He said that the recommended surgical treatment for chondroblastoma varies. Curettage either alone or in conjunction with bone grafting or packing the cavity with PMMA or coupled with cryosurgery are the techniques which are described in literature. Now he has said that after curettage, the recurrence rate is 10 to 35%. So everything, the whole of the gist of the paper has come up to now. Now this is the answer of the question. Here we write down ki why we want to do this study. This should always be in the last two or three lines, should be where we want to discuss what are our results we shall discuss and what will be the outcome of our paper. He said that our aim to this retrospective study was to evaluate the rate of recurrence after curettage, then intralesion curettage, and to define the associated factors in view of the aggression of this aggressive behavior of this tumor and to evaluate the functional outcome. So he had said that we shall find out only these three things: local recurrence, functional outcome, and what is the behavior of the tumor in the head of the femur, head of the humerus, around knee like that, or in view of the size or its histological way. So this is one of the most almost an ideal introduction for the search. And this kind of research we do orthopedic surgeons. RCT and meta-analysis, these are done by only if your institute has research wings. Next is material and methods. This is also a very important subheading of the article. Please do not exaggerate the numbers. In material method, if you have 10 numbers, 10 patients, write down only 10. So many times of 10 you make try to 50, you avoid this. This is a plagiarism and unethical. If you have good results of the 10 patients and you have 7 are good, that is more than important. Dr. Bhauk is very particular about this. I have given so many articles to him, and he has said that there is a lot of plagiarisms in this, and those were so many of them were Chinese articles. And that is why I'm saying, be honest. We should be very honest. Your 5 cases with 4 good results are better than your 50 cases with 45 good results. Do not cut and paste from the thesis or elsewhere. I have seen some theses, even they're doing in future tense, because they have cut and paste from plan. So you have to read it. Even this mistake is made by postgraduate students, and this shows that the guide has also not read the thesis. So you always write down and then show it to your guide and somebody else also. There is no harm. So, and each and every line should be read, each and every line. Do not skip the paragraphs. So be careful about the numbers and variables. And so many times, the number in abstract is 20, the number in material method is 25, and in discussion is 28. So this means at the three different sites, the number is changing. This means your data is not true. So you will have to, sometimes by mistake it can be, one or two numbers can be different, but in different parts of your paper, the number should not be different. We have to be very careful. So be careful about the number and variable. These should be matching with the numbers of those. Even if you do some plagiarism, it should be at least matching. In the abstract, results and discussion, keep these as simple as possible and as equal as possible. Avoid the name of the institute. So many times, if you write down that my institute and it has gone to the peer review, if he is jealous of you, he will reject your paper. Or if he is your friend, he will say, even in spite of poor paper, he may say some removable objection, and then paper may be accepted. So avoid institute, name of the author, name of the institute, even name of the country from the material method. Avoid trade names and make the list of inclusions. So, So these are the effective, begin with this, we have discussed these things. I'm directly coming to this portion. Now this is the patients and material. Now this is a prototype from the same article. We performed a retrospective study of 70 patients with chondroblastoma who had been referred to an orthopedic oncology unit from 1974 to 2000. So he has included a year, a time period, retrospective analysis. And diagnosis was made on which criteria? He has reviewed the past x-rays and the records from the hospital and histological slides. Then age at presentation, gender, presenting symptoms, anatomical site, these variables they have discussed in results. There were 70 patients and he has kept only 53 because rest of the 17 patients, either they have lost the follow-up or they were not matching the disease. Then radiological presentation, he had discussed in this, and he has put a reference that whether this growth plate was closed, whether the lesions were latent, active, or aggressive. there is no harm of putting of the reference in the even in the material methods. Then status of the this physis, open, closing or closed. We had discussed a little bit about this in the, he has written in the material. Now all the patients were treated initially by curettage alone. The wall of the cavity were burred and the defect washed with saline. In later years, pulse lavage was used whenever possible, and this was done under direct vision. In this, here we can slightly improve upon that. In this much number of the patient we did, and in this much number of the patient we have to specify within numbers also. And all the patients were followed up by plain radiography at 3 monthly interval for 2 years and 6 monthly thereafter for 5 years. And since 1992, any recurrence of the symptoms or abnormality identified on plain X-ray has been followed by repeat MRI. This means before 92, he has agreed that there was no MRI available, or they were doing very less MRI. So local recurrence was confirmed by histological evidence of chondroblastoma and discovered at any subsequent operation. The functional outcome was assessed by MSTS score, and he has again given the reference. So this means he has data about the disease, about the operation done, outcome, and then functional scoring. So this was the sequence he has used, and this is one of the ideal material and method written by Professor Rob Grimer. So I am very thankful to you, sir, and I have searched this slides from Google search and JBGS article.